Welcome back once again. We are now in our final video of this series dealing with introduction to marker and margin using our example question, James Bond, to demonstrate the concept of how to use our markup or margin to calculate our gross profit to either arrive at our sales or purchases figure and help us to arrive at missing figures. And in this question, we would have had our margin given to us as 30% of our sales. We would have given cost of sales of $91,700. And we recognize from the concept that margin does not go with cost of sales. Margin is associated with your sales or selling price, whereas markup is associated with your cost of sales or your cost price. So in this question, we had to convert our margin to a markup in order to find out what our gross profit would have been and by calculating it on our cost of sales. And we recognize from our question that our markup was then 30 on 70. And if you work it as a percentage, it is 45.8 with a lot of other figures behind it percent. But so we wanted to make sure that we have a nice whole number that we can work with for our gross profit and a more accurate figure. So we decided that we will work our markup as a fraction rather than a percentage, because remember that markup can either be expressed as a fraction or a percentage. And similarly, margin can also be expressed as a fraction or a percentage. So now we are about to culminate and we're about to complete our question. And we are going to do, in the previous video, we would have looked at our income statement for our James Bond, and we came up with a net profit of $13,700. So what we're going to do for our James Bond now would be the balance sheet or statement of financial position. And this is as at the 31st of March, 1985. So our balance sheet is going to start with our fixed assets, or what we call our non-current assets. And they didn't list any assets. They just told us that the fixed asset are cost. So you have your fixed assets at cost. So the cost was $8,000. And then we had a depreciation on these assets of $800. So we have, when you subtract your depreciation from your cost, you will come up with a net book value. And the net book value for our fixed assets, $8,000 minus $800, is $7,200. So that is our fixed assets, or our, if I use the new term, which is our non-current assets. So I can also call this non-current assets. Yeah, because we can use the new term, non-current assets. And then we can come up with our current assets. So we can say non-current assets, or we can say fixed assets at cost. So then we're going to look at our current assets. So we're going to classify our current assets. So our current assets would be based on the question. Let's look at the question. Our current assets at the ending are stock in trade, which is our closing inventory or closing stock. Our debtors, our balance at the bank, those are our assets. We don't have any prepaid expenses or accrued revenues. So we just put in what we have here, $21,200, $12,400, and $15,000. So let's go and put in our bank figures, our figures for our current assets, closing stock or inventory, which is $21,200. Our trade debtors, our accounts receivable or trade receivables, either those terms work, $12,400. And the bank is $15,000. So then we get our total current assets. I'm gonna add those together. $48,600 current total total current assets. And then when we add our current assets and our non-current assets together, we get our total assets. So $7,200 plus $48,600 gives us total assets of $55,800. Our total assets, $55,800. So what we're going to do, we're going to subtract our liabilities. So let's look at our liabilities. The only liability that we have is our trade creditors of $4,900. We don't have any prepaid revenues. We don't have any accrued expenses. So we only have trade creditors as our liability. We don't have any long-term or non-current liabilities because we don't have any loans. So, but if we did, we would have to classify those as well. We only have current liabilities of our creditors. So let's put in our current liabilities. So we are going to say less liabilities, and that would be current liabilities. And that would be our trade creditors. And because that's the only one, we take it right over. Our trade creditors is $4,800. And we are going to, to subtract our trade creditors from which will become now our total. So our trade creditors become our total liabilities. So we're going to subtract that from our total assets, which will give us our net assets. So 55,800 in total assets minus 4,900 in total liabilities gives us our net assets. Give us net assets of $50,900. So we have $50,900 in net assets. So all of this is going to be financed by our opening capital. So capital at 1st of April 1984. And what was that figure? Go back to the original, the first step that we did. When we did the statement of affairs, basically, or we did our accounting equation to work our opening capital, that was $43,000. So we are going to put in our opening capital of $43,000. To that, we are going to add our net profit that we just calculated. So our net profit is $13,700. So we're going to add that. So 43,000 plus 13,700. And then we are going to subtract our drawings. And how much is our drawings? We go back to the bank account where we calculated the drawings earlier on of $5,800. So we're going to subtract our drawings of $5,800. So then this is going to give us our capital at 31st of March 1985. So 56,700 minus 5,800 in drawings gives us capital at 31st of March 1985. So this will complete our question, example question on the markup and margin and how to use that in a question in order to work out missing figures that you may not know. So I trust that this series of videos were helpful to you. So what you can do is to like the video, and you can subscribe to the channel as well.